What's going on, guys? Hope everyone's having a good quarantine, safe at home. I thought I would take this time to make a little video about pack jobs, more specifically high performance and hyper performance canopy pack jobs. It's a subject that's sometimes overlooked, and I think it's very important to have to make you have a pleasant jump, to have a nice opening, and just make the whole experience of packing, which can be considered the worst part of skydiving, to make it a little bit more pleasant and easier. So I'm going to give my personal opinion and my personal techniques that I've managed to either learn from other people or come up with myself, and that has made me a better packer, made me get better openings, and overall just better skydiving experience. Of course, I would love for everybody to share their own personal techniques and their own personal opinions. And of course, this is only the way I do it. It doesn't mean other ways are wrong. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first thing we do, of course, is we stow our brakes. It's pretty much mandatory and everybody does it. I personally do it as soon as I land, even before. Of course, I don't do it on the packing area, on the landing area. I don't do it on the landing area because I don't want to have my canopy out on the sun a long time. So I prefer just picking up my canopy and doing it once I get to the packing area. I lay down my canopy, and while the rig is still on my shoulders, I will stow my brakes and assemble my RDS. It's not the case in the video because I was making a video, but it's usually when I do. Unless I have a backup and I don't really have time, just need to go again on the next load, I won't do it, but pretty much 70 or 90% of the times, I will do it with a canopy on my shoulders. It's pretty easy to do. There's not really much to it. The only thing I will say is stow your brakes correctly, okay? Don't do any crazy stowings, and make sure your risers are usable. Don't use beat up old risers, especially on high performance canopies, where if for some reason while the risers are exiting the main container, they can rub against either the reserve container or the flaps that are on the side, and unstow your brakes. If you have unstowed brakes even before the canopy starts to inflate, it tends to spin and cause line twists. And even if it doesn't cause line twists, if you have a highly loaded canopy, if it's not a high wing loading, it will start spinning very fast. And if you have a Petra and for some reason when you open you get two or three line twists and an unstowed one of your brakes is unstowed, you are going to chop that canopy unless you have ninja reflexes. I will put a video up now of that happening to me. Coming straight from the dark, I'm a shark, I'ma rip your shit like a slasher scene. Yeah, give me the racket for the brain. Give me the fucking shit to make the people go insane. Give me the fucking drug we call a music on this track. Give me the fucking wrist we're gonna use to bring it back. Bring it back. Give me the racket for the brain. Give me the fucking shit to make the people go insane. Give me the fucking drug we call a music on this track. Give me the fucking wrist we're gonna use to bring it back. Bring it back. It's pretty crazy, but I managed to hold it. But it's definitely an experience we do not want to live because it's boring. And cutting away, it's never cool. So, moving on. The next thing we do is just get ready to pack. So, pick up your weight, whatever weight you use. Or even if you don't use weight, you can start right ahead. But I would like to give you guys a little tip, which is when you put the weight, make sure the both risers are evenly, okay? Don't just throw the weight carelessly. Some people just put it holding the rig. I prefer to put it on the leg straps, and I aligned both hardware from the leg straps in order to make them even. And that will make your whole pack job much easier. You won't have to pull on one of the risers to make it get even. It will just already be as straight as it can be. So just align both leg straps, and they kind of create a little crater for you to put your weight bag or whatever you're using to create weight. It will make a nice little crater for you to put there, set there the weight, and then you can just start packing right away. After that, it's pretty much what you learn on your packing course, which is just grab the lines in the way we all know, putting them on between your fingers, and going up the canopy in order to remove any line twists or any unwanted torsions we might have. This, with time, you'll understand that the way you put the canopy down after you land will make it much easier to pack. If you just throw it forwards or if you just grab one of the risers to pull it down, it will sometimes come a little bit twisted. I prefer to put it down nice and neatly, like if I was kiting my canopy and I just pull both rear risers and set it down. It sets it down super neatly and I can just pick it up. It's gonna be like a mushroom on my hand. Once I start packing, it's much easier. So after that, of course, if you haven't already assembled your slider, your RDS, you should do it now, of course. It's pretty easy and there's really not much I can say about it. Each company has their own manual how to do this. I personally use N0 Sports Canopy, so I consider it to be the best system simply because it's fast to assemble and it's super easy to remove. Some other systems, you kind of have to pull on the slider a little bit, especially when it's older, and it sucks doing that. I just like this one. It's very fail-proof. I've never had any problems with this system whatsoever. It's really the best around, in my opinion, of course. The only thing I can tell you is if for some reason someone less experienced is packing your canopy, which sometimes does happen, make sure they know how to assemble the slider. A poorly assembled slider can be a cutaway or a really shitty opening that's gonna fuck up your back real good. So make sure you pay attention to that. And assemble, of course, with a lanyard facing the trailing edge of the canopy. That's pretty obvious. I shouldn't have to say that. So after I finish assembling the RDS, I like to split my canopy in half, the front riser lines to one side and the rear riser lines to the other side, and make it nice and flat, just like you're seeing on the video, like you're compressing an accordion, and just count your cells like you'll do on any other canopy. The only important part here is that these kind of canopies, they're not big, so they won't flap around and they won't fall and create like curves. So they will be pretty much flat laying on your lap. And this means you can really straighten them out and remove any like torsions and the folds on the fabric that are not supposed to be there. And you can make it really flat and you can really understand if you have any line overs or anything like that. Because they are so small, it's really easy to see where all the lines are going and how the fabric is. Don't forget while you are counting the cells, once you get to the cell number 5 or number 4, depending on how many cells your canopy has, pull the slider a little bit and expose it right there. It will be easier to keep it in check for when we are closing our pro pack. Just pull it up, open it a little bit. It will give you a better opening. After that, I will open the canopy once again. I will make it nice and flat in order to see that everything is falling where it should, and I'm gonna put the cells between my legs. And N0 Sports canopies have some of them, or most of them, have a power band, so you should have about the width of the power band between your legs, tucked in your knees. You don't need to squeeze them, you just need to hold them there, and of course you don't need to put the whole canopy, just again the area of the power band, which is basically the useful area of the cells when we are packing the canopy during the opening. Of course, it's the useful area of cells that are going to have an effect on your opening. Just like that little bit of the leading edge between your legs, and then of course set the canopy and quarter your slider in order to divide the canopy in two. Then make sure in this moment you'll see if you have any of the brake lines twisted in each other, and you really are able to create a nice and even and symmetrical pack chop, which is the most important thing when packing and when you want to have a good solid on-heading opening. It's having a symmetrical pack chop. Okay, this is gonna avoid any shaking, any line twists. It's pretty much having a symmetry on your pack chop. So it's what I'm doing, and after that I'm just grabbing the slider lanyard, making sure it's straight, coming straight from the slider, not coming around anything. Straight from the slider to behind my neck, and always has a free passage, never going around any lines. Then I'll just pull the slider a little bit, making sure everything is quartered now. So we have the first quarter of the slider is between my legs, the other two are to my sides, and the fourth is in front. And what I do is the excess fabric of the corners of the trailing edge, they're kind of hardened, they have double fabrics there. So all of that fabric, I usually straighten it out in order to make nice and even flaps, and I will tuck it in to the slide inside the to the sides of the slider. As you can see, I'm grabbing the fabric and tucking it in, making a nice and neat package. This will just mean when the canopy is inflating, it will inflate much evenly because everything is just tucked in nicely, okay? It won't have any extra drag on one side that will make one side inflate faster than the other. It will just be a nice and even opening. And plus, the slider is nice and exposed. Once the canopy, the Pro Pack does open up, the slider will be exposed and it will open up immediately and give you a nice and smooth opening. After that, just grab the center of the trailing edge, as I'm doing right here. And you will align. Usually there's a warning label on NDR Sports canopy. Some of them I have it on the underside, some older models, but it's usually on the top. And you just want to align it, the center stitching. If you have mini ribs, align the center stitch of the mini rib with the lines. If you don't have mini ribs, you will have to center it out. There's two stitch lines for the, because it's if you have a tri-cell system without mini ribs, you'll just have to find the center mini cell and align more or less the center. Doesn't need to be perfect, but accuracy does help. And of course, the logo will help you align it pretty easily. Then you just pick up both sides of the trailing edge and you do what I'm doing here. I'm just putting my knee, and the knee is there just to hold the center fabric from coming loose. And I'm not pushing anything in. I'm just putting my knee there to hold everything in place, and then using the trailing edge, the center trailing edge, to pull tension on the top skin and make the pack drop and create the Pro Pack. I'll do that on both sides. Once one of the sides is done, I will usually turn the canopy a little bit to the side and just rest the side I already finished on my lap, and then do it on the other side, as you can see here. And once I created this cocoon with the top skin, or rather with the trailing edge, for the rest of the canopy to be folded in. After this, I will do the most important part when you want to have a non-heading opening, which is I will expose the front part of the slider, or the only part of the slider we're going to have exposed now, and I am going to fold inwards and tuck inwards both cells on both sides. So you basically grab the end cell of each side, you tuck it in order to kind of hide the other cells. What this means is, as soon as this front part, the trailing edge of the canopy, the leading edge, sorry, as soon as the leading edge of the canopy is exposed to the relative wind, it will inflate the slider, and after that, only after that, will it start inflating the cells. So in a split second, you'll have the slider opened, and then you'll have the cells starting to inflate, which means the slider will be inflated first, and then the canopy will start its inflation. It helps with the openings 100%. It's amazing. After that, there's another technique which I really like. I will just grab both sides of the trailing edge that I'm using to close, and I will just create a little bit of tension in order to remove some of the air. This will make it just easier once I put the canopy down. I will remove a little bit of air. Then what I will do is I will change hands. I will change the hands in order to hold with my right hand the left side of the trailing edge, and with my right hand the left side of the trailing edge, and I will cross them in order to make a triangle, as you can see on the video, and I will pull the canopy tight to make a nice neat package, and of course I will remove the air. This is done opposed to twisting the trailing edge together, which works. If you like to do it, no problem. What I think that does basically is, first, it creates more time for the canopy to inflate, which means it will be closed in the Pro Pack longer, causing a bigger likelihood of you having line twists. Not only that, but once you wrap the canopy and the relative wind pushes it open, it will be a very aggressive untwisting of the canopy, which means all those creases are going to be ripped apart. And with time, it's going to degrade your canopy much faster. And because those little folds will be permanent, it will mean the trailing edge of your canopy will never inflate to its fullest, like it would if you were to do this along the life of the canopy. So if you buy a brand new canopy and you all just do this, once it has 2,000 jumps, 1,500 jumps, you're going to notice it flies better. So just take care of your gear and don't just twist it because you have to. I've done this for thousands of jumps, literally, and I've never had complaints, neither from me nor from the people I've packed for. So the fun part now is, of course, creating tension to the canopy and doing this little dance to put it down. It's pretty necessary because your hands are kind of twisted and you look particular Once you're doing this, you look kind of weird, but it gets the job done. And as you can see, you have a perfect pro pack. Just make sure, as you can see over there, the RDS lanyard isn't wrapped around anything. It's coming straight from the top of all lines, and it's not twisting on anything. And just pull it aside and make sure it's not in the way. I reckon, it never happened to me, but I reckon if you have your RDS lanyard wrapped around your line, it's not a fun opening, but I've never had problems with RDS myself. After that, I like to come from behind the canopy and remove some of the air. This is good because it allows me to put tension on the top skin, as you can see here, and have a nice, neat triangle without any crazy bends. Everything is predictable, everything is in sight, and I know all that I've done inside of that pro pack is perfect, and the outside, of course, is perfect as well. Then, of course, tension, knees on the warning label, not putting your knees over anything, and here's what I do. I find this little stitch line, as you can see here, of the center tricell, and I just pick it up and I bend it. I don't tuck it in. I actually bend it in order to avoid wrapping my canopy. I don't want to wrap my canopy and make twists inside. There is lines there. There's important fabric there. I don't want to wrap it. I just want to do a nice fold that I know will come out evenly and not with the tension knots and all that. So it's just a fold and then two more folds. One of them, instead of doing the three folds you have to do, is just these two because the canopy is so small. So remember, you just wrap that excess fabric on the top in order to make it flat, but not too excessive, and just lift the canopy up and bend it inwards. It's pretty easy. It's a very effective way, and if you have a big canopy, you can't really do it, but with these small canopies, there's no excuse for a canopy under 100 feet to be wrapped and to have crazy twists. No, just two folds and you're done. After that, let's put it in the bag. Pretty easy, pretty simple. I like, because I use RDS on my canopies all the time, I like to put the soft link that connects the RDS lanyard to the bag itself. I will put it more or less where it would be if it was a regular pack job. That way I can hold it with my knee and pack and put the canopy in the bag normally, as if it were a normal canopy. And as you can see, the lanyard is there separated. It's not in the way of anything. As you can see, when I was cocking my pilot chute, I did it with that window that you have to check if it's cocked or not. I don't recommend you do it there. I did it there because I put the canopy down, and because I was recording the video, I didn't want to pass in front of the camera, so I just started to put it on the bag. But usually, when I put it on the ground, I will pick up the RDS, put it closer to my canopy in order to not occupy as much space on the landing area, on the packing area, sorry, and I will cock it there, and it's done. After that, we'll pick up the lanyard and fold it on your hands evenly. No need to do any crazy folds, just simple, and just tuck it in. Some bags have a little pocket for you to tuck it in. Maybe, I've heard it helps increase the lifespan of your canopy. To me, I don't have enough experience yet with old canopies to tell if that's true or not, so I'll move on. And after that, depending on how many grommets your bag has, you'll either start on one side, on the center, like mine that has 3 grommets, or you'll have to start on one of the sides when you have 4 grommets. It's pretty much the same. The only thing I can tell you is fold your lines in small parts. Don't make super big folds, because the bigger it is, the longer it will take to exit, and the more time the bag will be exposed to the relative wind and has the ability to spin. So make really small folds on your lines and double stow. Please double stow. I'm not going to get into double stowing, why it's better, but I double stow on all of my canopies, on all the elastics. And as long as you don't have a crazy big canopy on a crazy small bag, you'll be able to double stow if you pack it correctly. I always double stow. I always have double stowed. I never had cutaways because of double stowing. It's better. It's just better. Okay? So just double stow and let's not talk about it anymore. There's really not much I can tell you about this. This is pretty much the same on all canopies. You do a small fold, double stow, and keep going. Make sure it's symmetrical. Make sure the lines are not coming out of the dimensions of the bag. Make sure the lines are within the size of the bag and the folds are within the size of the bag. This will just mean all the lines will be stowed on the bottom of the container and not on the sides, which means when the bag exits the container, the lines will be coming out from just one side and not from both sides of the container. Less chance of you breaking an elastic and having a loose line, or just having a loose line because it was rubbing and it came off. So it's a good practice to make nice, symmetrical, neat line stows. I like to put the bag between my legs. Just makes it faster after I put the first three rubber bands. But you do whatever you prefer. I'm just used to doing it like this. After that, once I'm finished, I will have more or less the size of the risers in extra lines. So I will just put my hand on the lines and on the bag in order to avoid the bag spinning, and in order to not loosen one of the bands, I will remove the weight and I will set the bag with my hand, of course, always holding the lines. I will set the bag in the place where the weight was, which is between the leg straps, as you can see over there on the video. After that, I will begin my work preparing the container to be closed. First things first, putting your risers on the flaps and on the side of the container. As you can see, I just give it a good tug and put them neatly and close the flap. A good technique, a good tip I can give you is do exactly as I'm doing. Put your knee on the shoulder strap, because what this will basically do is it will simulate your shoulder is there, and will mean the flaps will close as if your shoulder was there, which is how they're supposed to be closed. This is just easier, and I've just been so used to doing this. It's super fast and super easy to do. And just tuck them in without any twists, without anything over anything. Just put them in perfectly and on top of each other. And remember to try not to put the toggles exposed to any extra drag or anything, because when the container is opening, you might unstow a toggle, and that's not fun, of course. Then just close it, pull it back in order. I like to pull it back and kink the straps in order to make the flaps not open by accident. It just keeps them closed for longer. I would like to just point out that some people don't have magnetic riser covers, so because they have flaps, they need to keep them open, or they need to close the flaps and put the risers over the flaps when doing hop and pops. Again, I have Avalon rigs, which have magnetic risers with 3 magnets, and they don't have any like catch or any kinks that make it harder to open when in low speeds, so I just close them normally. Sometimes if I am on a plane and I'm going to do a hop and pop with a rig that's on mine, I will open the flaps before I exit. Some of the big names in competition that have other types of rigs will have the flaps closed and just put the risers over. To me, good. You can do that if you like to do that, if you prefer to do that. I just like to not have anything open or anything out of place, because I want to give a good example to students. When they look at my rig, I want them to see how a rig should look like, which is everything tucked in and everything out of the way. So I don't do that. It's a personal preference. You can do as you wish. Some people say it's safer. If you do have flaps, I do consider it to be safer. If you have magnets like the Avalon, which has very easy to remove, to slip out magnets, it's really no problem. So after that, we're going to prepare the container to receive the bag. First things first, put your pull-up cord, your pack boy, whatever you use. I use a pack boy. Pack boys are cool. And just prepare it. I open the top flap, pull it back, put on my pack boy in the loop, just hold it with my knee. Then I pick up the bag, use the bag to hold the pack boy and the loop in place, and go to the other side to start preparing my lines and preparing the container to receive the bag. I put the lines on the bottom of the container, making sure they're all in one place, not with any twists, not with any tension knots or any crazy stuff. And just put my bag in at a 45 degree angle, as you can see. The bridle, making sure the bridle is correctly routed. Then I will just with my hands dig in the bag into the container, and I will push the bag in order for it to sit evenly in all corners. Then I will pull the bottom flap up and put a little bit of tension on the loop just to make sure the reserve container and the main bag are sitting evenly and not uneven, I mean. And then just close your container as you have. Different brands have different ways to close, different routings of the bridle, and different orders of flaps. So you should refer to your owner's manual to see. Just make sure your bridle is not wrapped around anything, it's not carelessly thrown in there. Correctly route it, and you'll have nice and good safe openings. So Avalons have left side first. There's numbers on the flaps. So what I do is I just put my hand there to make sure the corners go over the bottom of the container, as you can see right here. I put my hand there and I just give it a little slap to make sure everything is closed as it should be. Finally, the moment everybody likes and some people have trouble with, which is putting the pin on the loop. Make sure your loop, again, I don't know why I have to say this, but make sure your loop is not worn. Make sure your loop is not in terrible condition. It's not too short, not too long. You'll have a nice skydiving life if you do all of that. After you pop in that loop, I usually just put the bridle where it should be, not putting it in tension, making it loose. So if there's any slight pulls, the container will not immediately open. So the slider is, the bridle is kind of loose. Close your flap, keep running your bridle into the side of the container as your manufacturer recommends, and then just fold your pilot chute. However you prefer to fold it, ignore my fold. This fold you shouldn't do, I don't recommend. I do, it works, it's like a base jumping fold. Just how I got used to do it, so that I could do it faster and I could just do it while the rig is between my legs. If you like to do it on the floor and do a nice, neat fold, all the more power to you. Then just tuck it in and you're good to go. Make sure your free fly tuck tab is tucked in correctly in order to not have a tragedy happen when you are free flying. Other than that, you are done and you are good to go. Now, one more thing I'd like to add, which is check your rig. Okay, check, inspect your work, inspect how your rig is. You don't know what happened, you don't know who touched it, so just inspect it real quick. So just go over the RSL, go over the three ring system, and just make sure everything is how it should be, your handles are how they should be, velcroed in correctly, your cypress is turned on, make sure everything is good. Don't board your plane with poorly put on, poorly closed flaps, poorly assembled rings. That's just not cool, and you'll probably be grounded for that, okay? Make sure everything is done. Other than that, I hope you guys have good jumps when the quarantine is over. Make sure you have good, safe back jobs and good, safe openings. Get out there, swoop if you like to swoop, free fly if you like to free fly, and I'll see you guys next time.